So the current understanding of colorectal cancer is that there are two distinct molecular pathways that lead to its development. The first and less common pathway leads to either sporadic colorectal cancer and or the development of hereditary nonpolyposis colorectal cancer, or HNPCC, which is also known as Lynch syndrome. And it's estimated that about 15% of colorectal cancers fall into this category. So in HNPCC, there is an autosomal dominant mutation in DNA mismatch repair genes. And this leads to what is called microsatellite instability. And recall that DNA mismatch repair mechanisms correct errors that spontaneously occur during DNA replication, like a mismatch in a single base or short insertions and deletions. And so rather than correcting these errors, the cells with defective mismatch repair genes tend to accumulate these types of errors. And as the cells replicate, the original gene sequence gets lost, and then these new microsatellite fragments are generated. And so what exactly is a microsatellite? A microsatellite is basically just a segment of repeated DNA. So for example, this short little sequence of just G, C, and T, and A repeated over and over would make up a microsatellite. And these little microsatellites can be detected by PCR. And so patients with this type of mutation develop sporadic colorectal lesions, and about 80% of these patients will progress to colorectal cancer. And the non-polyposis part of hereditary non-polyposis colorectal cancer means that the cancers occur when only a small number of polyps are present, or even when no polyps are present at all. And it usually involves the proximal colon. And because the underlying problem is a mutation in DNA mismatch repair, these patients are at a very high risk of other types of cancers, not surprisingly, including most commonly cancer of the endometrium, but also cancers of the ovaries, stomach, and elsewhere. Okay, so now let's make a little bit more room before we talk about the second pathway. So the second possible molecular pathway leads to what is called familial adenomatous polyposis, or FAP. And this pathway is believed to be involved in about 85% of colorectal cancers. So this mutation is also an autosomal dominant mutation, but the mutation is in a tumor suppressor gene instead of a DNA mismatch repair gene. And this leads to something called chromosomal instability. And the tumor suppressor gene that we're talking about is called the APC gene, or Adenomatous Polyposis Coli gene, on chromosome 5q. And so this is a problem of chromosomal instability, which, in other words, is an error that occurs in mitosis. So this APC gene encodes a protein that controls beta-catenin concentrations, and it also interacts with another protein called E-cadherin. Beta-catenin is involved in cell signaling, while E-cadherin is a protein that is involved in cell adhesion. So since the APC gene encodes a protein that helps control how often a cell divides and how it attaches to other cells in a tissue and whether a cell moves away from a tissue, you can kind of see how it plays a vital role in controlling tumor potential and thus is classified as a tumor suppressor gene. So let's kind of review the overall sequence of the progress of colorectal cancer in this pathway. We'll make a little bit more room to do that. So the sequence goes from normal colon to a colon that is at risk to the formation of what's called an adenoma, which is technically benign but also precancerous, and then the formation of a carcinoma, which is cancerous. And these are all steps in a sequence. So to get from a normal colon to a colon at risk, the first thing that happens is loss of the APC gene function. And so because we already reviewed the function of the APC gene, we know that this leads to decreased intracellular adhesion and then also an alteration in cell signaling that leads to increased proliferation. The next step in the sequence, in which the colon that is now at risk then goes on to form an adenoma, involves a mutation in KRAS. And the KRAS gene encodes a GTPase, which is a protein that is involved in cell signaling. And so a mutation in this gene leads to unregulated intracellular signal transduction. And then the final step in this sequence, in which you go from an adenoma to a cancerous carcinoma, is loss of the tumor suppressor gene P53. And this leads to increased tumorigenesis. And unlike in HNPCC, where 80% of patients progress to cancer, with familial adenomatous polyposis, 100% of patients will progress to colorectal cancer. And the location is also a little bit different. In FAP, the lesions are pancolonic, or involve the whole colon, and as well as the rectum. And they are two really great examples that demonstrate the various hallmarks of cancer, where one involves the mutation in a DNA mismatch repair gene that leads to microsatellite instability, whereas the other involves a mutation in a tumor suppressor gene leading to chromosomal instability.